Monday, Monday. Louie, you're still in bed.
Who's the chick wearing a mask?
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Coffee with Andy. I am your host, Andy, and here is my coffee. So we're glad you're all here this morning on this beautiful day on May 18th. We believe this is the start of week 9 for NAU virtual programming. So we're so glad that you're with us for another fantastic virtual adventure with your friends here at NAU. Our plan this morning, as usual, is to preview the schedule, have a little share so we can hear people's voices, learn about this date and history, and then we'll play a game that we played last week. We'll do another scavenger hunt, and then we will send you off on your adventure. But Benny, I saw that you were on Facebook. What did you notice on Facebook?
It's Morgan's birthday this morning.
Today is Morgan's birthday. So Morgan Abbott, one of the crew, one of the squad who hosts these programs, it is her birthday today. So she will definitely be on the dance party tonight. So we will do a little fun thing for her birthday. And if you want to say happy birthday, then that'll be the time. So it is Morgan's birthday. Thanks, Benny.
Yep.
All right. So let's get right to it. So I'm going to try my new fun trick. Share my iPad. Nope. Got rejected. It said no thanks because of the new Zoom update. So, you know, we'll be flexible. We'll be okay. So here we go. Today, it's coming, I swear, promise. Today is Monday. The plan this morning. Is it up?
No.
This is not off to a good start, everybody.
There it is.
Woo!
Yay!
So today is Monday. Our plan this morning is to have coffee with Andy, and then we will have yoga with Sarah. And I apologize to Sarah. I was misspelling her name. I fixed it this week. So Sarah with an H will host yoga without an H at 2 p.m. And then tonight we'll have the virtual dance party, and we will do a little celebration for Morgan, which will be fun. Any announcements that I missed on that? Okay, then on Tuesday, wonderful Tuesday. Mark, how's that walk going to be this week?
Andy, it's going to be 2 miles. It was so fun last week. Bring a water. If you can only do one, you can stop in the middle, but most of our athletes are rocking the 2 mile, Andy.
Oh, wow. That sounds good. I like to hear it. And then in the afternoon, Karen, we have our Karen.
Yeah, this week it's all about you guys. It's time to do a self-portrait.
Ooh.
One of our athletes, whenever I would watch her, I would see a picture in the background, and I asked her, I said, hey, did you draw that? Is that a self-portrait? And she said, yeah, she did a long time ago. So that's our theme for this week. So get ready. You can have a mirror with you. You can have a picture of you that you want to draw, or just do it from memory.
That sounds awesome. And then 7 p.m., we got trivia with Lujo. So as usual, and I'm always looking forward to their halftime show. So I don't know what they'll do yet, but they always have a good halftime show. On Wednesday, we start our days with Mark Kelly.
We're boxing, Andy. Emma and Mark are going to get you up and ready and boxing. So it's a ton of fun. It's one of my favorite things I do throughout the week.
At this point, you guys must be getting very good.
Oh, man, you should see these guys' punches. I know Ruth's on this call, man. If I took one of her uppercuts, I would be knocked out.
Ruth's always had a pretty good uppercut, though, I got to tell you.
I have to say, Andy, at the end of boxing, we go around and we check in. And one of the things that I often hear people say is that they feel energized and powerful. So if you want to feel energized and powerful, come to boxing.
Wow, I do want to feel that. I hope maybe I'll cancel some meetings.
That sounds
awesome. Benny, you got any Tigers boot camps updates?
Yeah, definitely. My dad is extremely excited. Hopefully Big Mike will be there this week. A challenge for that for the athletes. But yeah, I was saying that if you do 30 crunches or 25 push-ups, you will receive a O'Hara skip card.
Wait, Benny, say that again. That's amazing.
If the athletes do 30 crunches or 25 push-ups instead of the video, you get an O'Hara skip card.
That's amazing. What a great offer.
I had used one already.
You already did it?
Yeah.
Nice. You love doing push-ups and sit-ups. That's good. Thanks, Benny.
Yep.
So and then our Wednesday night is trivia is Family Feud with Morgan and Emma, right, Em?
That's right. Got some great new questions for you guys this week and another special guest.
Ooh.
That'd be awesome.
Brings us to Thursday. Zumba in the morning with Judy. Spotlighters in the afternoon and our virtual campfire on Thursday night, which we've now started giving away stuff, which is pretty fun. So there might be another raffle this week. I don't have too many updates. So. What, Emma?
Sorry. I was going to say, I hope so, because I need to keep practicing my counting.
And
I can't get the good morning starshine from the Aquarius show out of my head. It's been going in my head all week, so... Join us for some new songs and some. We had a great session last week. Everybody was really, really putting it out there. It's awesome.
It's amazing. Sounds good. And then at the campfire, the other thing we'll do, and we'll talk about this in a second, is we'll update our virtual hike of the AT. Guys, it's exciting. We've been getting a lot of posts on Facebook.
Yeah. And email.
People are being very active. It's really impressive.
And adding them up, it's pretty impressive.
Yeah. So in a second, I'll actually check in to see if people on the call, if they've been active and they want to report anything too. So that'll be our Thursday night, which will bring us to Friday. And on Friday, we will have our step dancing with Jen. I heard that was awesome last Friday.
It was. It was amazing. Come try it.
And then, of course, our virtual poetry slam and short stories with Glennon and Karen on Friday afternoon. And I think we're up to chapter 6 now in Harry Potter, which is when stuff really starts picking up. Hogwarts starts to be pretty interesting in chapter 6. So that'll be on Friday night.
Are those recordings on the YouTube channel?
I saved them. I think we need to put them up.
I was just going to say that. If anybody hasn't, like last week, I was my first time and I was feeling a little bit like I was stepping in the middle of the story, but I think it's okay. If you haven't been coming, but you want to join Harry Potter, I think it's okay to come in the middle. We can answer, I think Maggie will answer any questions.
And Brian Heffernan is great for updates. If we ever need updates on Monday morning to how it's going, he knows what's up.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's get him on here. Someone got him. There he is. Hi, Bri.
Hi. To get back to what you were saying about the Facebook and YouTube stuff, and to get with Tyson with my big announcement, is that my sister Evie just moved in for two weeks, so she could help us put all the stuff on together.
Yes, absolutely. Evie moved in with you guys, Bri?
For 2 weeks.
Awesome. So there she is. Evie.
Hey, there she is.
Tell Evie to pick a song because she's going to teach a dance tonight at the dance party. So that's going to be really good. Tell her to get ready. But Brian, did you have any Harry Potter updates? How's that going?
Harry Potter is doing great. You probably guess Maggie's living it. And apparently Jordan has been telling a lot of things that haven't been talked about yet.
Oh, he's given spoilers.
Yep.
Yeah. Well, that's awesome, Brian. Thanks for the update. And thanks for including yet another amazing sister. And then our weekly challenge this week is very exciting and tremendously delicious. we have a weekly challenge, the Athletes Unlimited Baking Contest. That's right. You have 1 week to bake something yummy, and don't forget to take a picture of your item before you eat it. We want athletes, parents, volunteers, and coaches to submit a picture of their baked goods to be entered in the contest. So we've seen Fraser's Spanish Lemon Cake, Joseph Chan's Scallion Pancakes, and volunteer Carlin Foreman's Lemon Doors, all on our Facebook page over the last few months. We can't wait to see what you bake this week, and you can post the pictures to the Facebook page. You can email them in to Mark, Karen, or Camp Eckerbridge, and we will share it with the group. This is very exciting. Now, I don't know, Emma, if you want to share that picture again, or should we wait to have that show up on Facebook?
Emma's muted.
Emma, you're just talking into the void.
Emma, you're muted.
Sorry, my post is really crunchy. I was trying not to make you able to see that. Yes.
Well,
I don't have it on my computer, but I can hold it up. Hold the picture.
Maybe we'll do it in a second. If you send it to me, I can get it up here.
Yeah, I can send it myself too.
I just want to say that this idea came on Friday when we were at the Poetry Slam, because every day it seems Brian Given tells us what he's made or baked or cooked or whatever, and he made something incredible on Friday, and that's when it. Lucy, Johanna, and I had all clicked at the same time. We went, oh, that's next week's challenge. So thank you, Brian.
Can I share what it was?
Because I can't remember.
It was this butternut squash with sugar and cinnamon.
That's right. We were drooling.
Yeah, and then the day before, I made grapefruit with cinnamon. Like, I baked the grapefruit, and I put the cinnamon on top.
Ooh. You're so good at that.
And today I'm doing something special. I can't say what.
Ooh, a surprise.
Yep, it's one of Andy's favorite foods of all.
Ooh.
Steak.
Interesting.
Steak.
Yep.
What is it?
All right, I have it. But before I put it up, Mom, is it okay with you if I share it?
Oh, yeah, sure.
She wasn't even going to put it on the Facebook group.
Oh, Carol Lee.
I know.
So, Carolee, what's in there?
Rhubarb and strawberries.
Ooh, and did you grow your own rhubarb?
Oh, yes. Rhubarb is ready to pick.
Ooh. And everybody, make sure you notice the special design on the bottom pie. It looks very familiar. Mm-hmm. Looks like an active person. It's the NAU logo.
That's extra credit, Andy. That is major extra credit. That's going to be hard to beat.
That's pretty good. That
the bar is high.
Yeah, that might be in the like the Carol Lee bracket.
Hall of Fame.
Karen, send that lady a shirt.
Send that lady a shirt.
I get lots of shirts.
Well, you might need another one.
Emma, there we go. And then the other person I wanted to check in with who really got me pretty excited this weekend. Where's Ruthie?
I got her.
Rudy.
Yes?
What was being baked in your house this weekend?
My mother made me blueberry muffins.
Gluten-free blueberry muffins, right?
Yeah.
Those looked spectacular.
Thank you.
Betty.
Benny, what's up?
No.
You said that they were gluten-free, right?
Yes.
Send me a few.
Can you see the picture on Facebook?
That picture on Facebook is also very, very delicious looking.
Yeah, my mom made them over this weekend.
Send me a couple of muffins. I want one.
Benny's willing to try out the gluten-free. How are you doing, Ruthie?
I'm great.
Good. Nice to see you. Ruthie, I got a special thing on this day just for you, just so you know.
We'll
get to it. Well, you'll see. You gotta wait.
Okay.
I saw somebody with a hand up at 10:90. Is that Madison?
Ow. Yes. Hi.
What's up? Or were you waving to Ben? All right, that's okay. No worries. So now, so we've previewed the week. We've talked about the weekly challenge. The other thing I wanted to talk about, let's do On This Day in History, and then we'll talk about the AT, and then we'll play our game. So today, May 18th, is a nice day. The most important thing that's happening today, in my world, is Morgan's birthday. That is a very important thing. And we have some interesting Massachusetts history today. But I won't bury the lead. Ruthie, in 1999, a certain musical group came out with a certain album that had a certain song. So what musical group do you love from the 1990s?
I wasn't born.
Yes, you were. What are you talking about? 1999, when we were at camp, What was the special, really popular group? There was five of them.
Five?
Mm-hmm.
You sang it on the bus?
They left and now they're back, all right.
It's, I think it's 98 Degrees.
Oh, no, a much better version of 98 Degrees.
I'm just kidding.
But it is a boy band.
Backstreet Boys.
Yes, the Backstreet Boys. In 1999, came out with the album Millennium.
Millennium. Yeah, I had that too.
Yeah, you did. Do you know what's the really famous song on the Millennium album?
I Want It That Way.
You know it, Rudy. So on this date in 1999, that album with that song came out and changed sing-alongs forever. That is also one of the highest-selling albums of all time, of any musical. Wow. So that was pretty cool. All right, so now we get into kind of the weirder trivia. So here's some Massachusetts trivia for you. In 1631, in Massachusetts, the right to vote was established. So that was a really important thing. However, it was established so that only members of the Congregational Church, who were men, were allowed to vote. So 109 people elected John Winthrop as the first governor of Massachusetts. So it was a start. We came a long way, but voting rights were established in Massachusetts in 1631 for a very specific group of people. And then this one's for Joanna, who's not on here right now. But in 1804, Napoleon was deemed the Emperor of France. So there's a world history thing, a Massachusetts history thing, and then most importantly, a Backstreet Boys history thing for us today. So that is some On This Date in History. So I see some hands up. Do people have things they want to share or things that they have questions about? Christina?
Yes. This week's challenge, I am going to make a watermelon ice cream cake, and I'm hoping to preview it at the campfire. But can we upload our recipes so we all have different recipes to share?
We would love if people did that. That's a great idea, Christina.
I'm very excited to make my watermelon ice cream cake for everybody.
Yes.
Sounds delicious. Do you deliver?
Yeah, exactly.
It's going to be, I hope it's a warm campfire for you. Well, I guess you'll be inside, so you'll be okay.
I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, delicious.
Yes.
Hi, Joey.
Hello.
What's up?
Not much. I wanted to share two things I did over the weekend.
Awesome.
One was I sent in emails to the Echo Camp or whatever that email is.
Yep, we got them.
I did 9 miles in 3 days on the treadmill, 3 miles each day.
I saw that. That's amazing.
Yeah, 3 miles a day. So it's like 47 minutes each day, something like that.
Yeah.
It was something ridiculous. And then I made 2 pizzas last night.
Ooh. What kind of pizza?
One vegetable with pepperoni and one with a pepperoni pizza with cheese.
Nice. Delicious. Thanks for sharing, Joey.
Yeah.
And I like your t-shirt. Go Pat.
Thank you. Yeah.
Hi, Patrick.
I did 5 miles of walks.
5 miles, Patrick?
Outside.
Wow. I'm writing it down.
Yes.
That's amazing. Did you walk with your family?
I walk with mom.
Did you see any animals or any birds or anything?
Chipmunks. Mm. I saw chipmunks.
Yeah. Thanks for sharing, Patrick. Hafenator?
I'm just curious. Are you serious about Evie putting a song request for the dance party?
You know I'm always somewhat serious.
Okay.
Yeah, Evie should definitely come to the dance party. She'll have fun. And if she has a song request, I promise her I will play it. And spotlight her on video. What's up, Ricky?
Yesterday I took about a 7-mile bike ride off to Central Square in Cambridge and home. I stopped by Soldiers Field Road because it was a nice day to go out biking and just to get out of the house.
Nice. That's pretty good. 7 miles. That does a lot for us, Rick.
Yep.
That's good. Hey, Andy, can we highlight Ricky? Because he was the winner of the challenge last week. He sang the Rainbow Connection. And if you haven't seen it, it's on Facebook. And it was really, really beautifully done.
It was really good.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.
You're welcome. It was really nice. You said it was one of your favorite songs from your childhood.
Yeah, basically. Since I've seen the Muppets movies and I've heard lots of people covering that song, especially Tori Kelly, one of my favorite current singers right now.
There's a Willie Nelson version too, Rick, that I love.
Yes, there is.
Oh, I haven't heard that one.
And Ray Charles. There's a lot of good ones. I was really happy you chose that song. Actually, Ricky, it was a really hard-fought competition this week. There were so many wonderful entries.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Made me really happy to go through and see them. So congratulations to everybody who showed off their talents this week.
Mm-hmm. Thanks.
Patty.
Hi.
What's up?
I'm happy that it's May, and May's a good month. Mm-hmm. We opened my pool.
Ooh. That's and awesome.
This Friday is my mom's birthday.
See? What a great month.
Yeah. Anything else, Andy?
What else?
I'm doing a treadmill today for 16 minutes.
Wow. That's awesome.
And then another thing, Andy.
I'm sure, I understand.
Yep.
What Cameron's talking about, the song Sunshine, I'm going to practice today down the treadmill.
Sounds great, Patty.
See, it's like all of our AU things coming together in one activity.
Yep.
I would say eat something that was baked at the same time, but that wouldn't make any sense to do.
Well, my mom made our spread.
Oh, see, there we go. Awesome. Delicious. Thanks, Patty. Let me see. I see hands up. I'm trying to see people. Hi, Jillian.
Hi. Sorry about that.
No worries.
She's calling me because I'm talking to her. So, but so I want to let you know I post a lot of songs, for that contest, whatever call that thing, and I baked today. I baked yesterday.
What'd you bake?
One of my mom's favorite appetizers is out of my mom's recipe, actually, because I miss my mom so much.
What was it?
So, it's called pepperoni pinwheels.
Mm.
Almost like a pizza, but no sauce.
Mm.
I did part one, and that's going to be a part two today.
Oh, wow. You're giving us like a teaser, too.
Yeah, and also, if I win, just letting you know, if I did, then my sister is posting a video, and a Disney song's background.
Oh, fun. That's awesome.
If I win, I hope I get that. I'm dying to have a t-shirt. I'm dying to have a t-shirt. Come on, pink. Pink.
Ooh, I don't know. Do we have pink NAU t-shirts?
We don't.
There was that beautiful, like, pinkish red one from Summer Games.
Oh, the Raspberry Sangria.
Mm.
That was the name of that shirt. Yeah, that.
Love that shirt.
I think I have that here. I might have to wear that tomorrow.
And which, by the way, I might have sangria at 5 o'clock somewhere.
Maybe in like Eastern Europe at the moment, but not here right now.
Yeah.
We might have to get on the squad locker and get some pink. What would we call them? Some azaleas, some of that floral color. Mm-hmm. So I see somebody has joined the call and is sitting with Carol Lee. So Steve is here. What's up, dude? So Steve, I know you've probably been lurking in the background as you often do. So you probably heard that Patrick already reported he did 5 miles, Rick biked 7, Joey did 3 different 3-mile treadmill activities. We had lots of people outside. Ben Majeski's holding up his step counter. Christina Smith, you did a walk this weekend, right?
Yeah, Saturday and Sunday.
So you did 2 long walks?
Yeah.
Wow, awesome. So Steve, there's a lot going on here.
You guys are killing it, you know. You better slow down or you're going to get this thing done in a week. I mean, that would be no.
Andy, I've been keeping like an unofficial tally. I don't know if you want to give like an update of where we're at currently.
Sure, absolutely.
Based on what I've heard, I know people shared things on Friday at poetry. And I was looking at the Facebook, and then I just added up the things that people shared today, and it looks like we're around mile 130.
Oh. That means we're incredible. Already in Tennessee.
We're already in Tennessee, and we only started on Thursday night.
We left from Georgia, and we'd walked through the northern part of Georgia and went to Tennessee. So
it's incredible.
So we're averaging about, what do we think? About 45 miles a day. That's pretty good.
On my best day walking all day long, I could only do about 18. Mm.
See, things are better in teams.
That's
right.
It.
That's right.
Also, if this was the pace, I might do the AT. But so let's see, Benny, what we got?
Well, I wanted to keep it updated. There's going to be an announcement today from the governor. I don't know when it's coming, but it's coming today. Also, I and me and Sam Higgins went for a walk Saturday night. Sam posted it on the Facebook chat. And we had a birthday this past week for our housemate Jason.
Yeah.
And I hope today it'll be I hope today I am I've week clinics this week. Tomorrow and Wednesday and Friday.
Cool. Thanks, Benny. So I see John Ray on here. Good morning, John Ray.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm so excited about all the walking.
Isn't it awesome?
I've out on this. That's impressive.
Yeah.
So we're hiking the Appalachian Trail, John.
You are.
We are.
I've always wanted to do that. Always wanted to do that.
Yeah.
Wow.
So we're going to walk and we're going to give updates. And on Thursday night, we're going to go back to Steve and he's going to tell us more about the trail and help us understand it. This is all inspired by you, actually, John.
So I'm impressed. Is this just athletes or is this coaches or?
It's everybody.
Our whole team, our whole family.
We're all in this together.
I'm putting in about 30 miles a week.
Ooh, wow.
There we go.
So I have a dog. Do I divide that by 4?
Yes. Well, I have a great housemate named Amanda, and I watch her walk from my porch, so I think that counts.
She goes
around the neighborhood, and I just go, one, two. Oh, that's good.
Take a dog for a walk.
All right, I'll go steal one. But yes, everybody, if you're walking your dog, that counts. If you're out with your family and friends, that counts. If you're on treadmills, that counts. If you're able to wheel your wheelchair around, that counts. Anything like that counts towards our hike of the Appalachian Trail. Ricky's bike ride, that counts. All of this is great. Jogging, Richie, counts. All of it.
I know Ryan Osborne walked some golfing on Friday. That would count too, Andy, wouldn't it?
Andy, we went golfing yesterday up in the golf course, Andy, yesterday.
Who won, Ray?
We walked about 15, 20 miles. On the
Whoa. All together, yeah. Who'd you go with?
Okay. People and mom.
Oh, you went with people and mom.
So what's the schedule for today, Andy, in the map?
Glad you asked, Ryan. We have coffee with Andy, then we have yoga, and tonight we have the dance party.
I'll see you tonight.
All right.
So you tell them that you walk the golf course 18 holes on Friday.
18 holes on Friday.
That's awesome, Ryan. That's usually 5 or 6 miles. That's pretty good.
That was the highlight of the weekend.
Absolutely.
We weren't cooking.
Maybe we should be cooking. We were takeout from Patty's Friday night.
All right. Delicious. Nice job, Osbournes. Hey, Beth Garlic. Beth, hey.
Hey, yeah.
How you doing?
Good.
Did you go for some walks this weekend? Beth?
Yeah.
You did? Did you take Winnie?
No.
You didn't take Winnie? That's okay.
We went for a ride.
Yeah. That's good.
Where did we go to? I will follow Mom.
Nice. Very cool.
What do we did?
All right. Looking around. Brian, I've heard from you. I'm going to try to call on some people we haven't heard from. Let me see. Hey, Louie.
Hey.
What's going on?
Nothing much, you.
How was your weekend?
Fine. From the other day, we just took a ride down from the other day. It is for my highlight for the weekend. And on Saturday, I just spoke to my big bro.
Nice. Good old Nicholas.
Yep. And Bobby sent in some starting from the rest of the morning until the next day, until Tuesday. About Bobby sent in about the new video about the American friendship bracelet. Of videos is for the next day until Tuesday is for art with Karen.
Oh, making friendship bracelets.
Yeah.
Cool. That's a great thing.
Wow.
Yeah.
Thanks, Lou.
Yeah.
Andy, can I introduce someone who is kind of new to the group?
Yep.
Okay, so some of you old school camp people, like Brian, Ben, Adam, Ryan, you might remember my cousin Siri, who used to come to camp during the summer. Siri's mom, Wendy, is here. Where did
Hi,
I not?
Wendy.
You didn't unmute her, but you got it.
Hang on, Wen.
It's good to be here.
Hi, Aunt Wendy.
Hi, everybody. It's good to be here.
Well, thanks for joining us. Wendy lives in Vermont, but she didn't want to miss coffee with Andy. So if you see her on Zooms, I just wanted you all to know who she is. She's pretty awesome. She's a farmer and an awesome mom and an awesome aunt. So make sure you say hi
to her.
Thanks,
Sam.
You're welcome.
Well, it's great to be here.
We're glad you came.
Thanks.
So Aunt Wendy's with us from Vermont. Christina's with us from New Hampshire. We've got a couple of the, and I think Dale, are you still in New York?
Yes, I'm coming back on next Saturday.
What is that? Well, so I'm
coming back next Saturday.
Yeah, planning on coming back. So we got four states represented here this morning. That's pretty cool. Dale, how are you?
Good.
Anything fun this weekend?
I took two walks today. I took one with 10 o'clock, I think, was my dog, the giant dog. And I took one with my mom with the dog around Kings Point Park.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah.
Very cool. It's nice to see you.
Yeah.
Christina. You said you went for a walk, right?
Yes.
And how was the rest of your weekend?
Awesome.
Anything fun?
No.
Other than the walks. The walks were fun, yeah. Right? That's good. Well, we're glad you're here. Good morning. John Ray, I see you with your hand up.
So one of the things we do before we go to bed at night, the three of us anyhow, sometimes four of us, we ask each other how many steps or how many miles they did every day. So what I'd like to do is challenge you to extend this walking to all the immediate members of your family. Because they need the exercise as much as you do. How's that?
Pretty good.
Thank you.
Good. I see Patrick giving a thumbs up, Brian smiling. Good morning, Gabby. How are you?
Doing okay.
Doing okay. Did you do any walks this weekend? Anything active?
I did some dancing on Friday night.
Some dancing? And you posted on Facebook that you did do some activities, right?
Yeah.
So tell us about it. How'd it go?
I got 13,000 steps on Friday from the dancing.
Wow.
Oh, that is really impressive. Nice job, Gabby.
Good job.
I'm scrolling. Good morning, Nick Christopher.
Good morning.
How are you?
Great.
Did you go for any walks this weekend?
Yes.
Yes. Did you walk with anyone?
Yes.
Who did you walk with?
My mom.
That's nice. Did you go on a long walk or a short walk?
Long walk.
Nice. Great job, Nick. Thanks for helping us out.
Welcome.
Let me see. Who else? Hi, Danny.
Hi.
What's going on? Good. How are you? How was your weekend?
It was good. Yesterday, I went for an hour walk.
Wow. Did you get that, Emma? Write that down.
I got it. I'm keeping track.
That's awesome, Danny. Was it nice? Did you feel good when you were done?
Huh?
Did you feel good when you were done? Did it feel good to go on a long walk?
Yeah.
Awesome. Nice to see you again, Danny. I heard from Rudy. I heard from Gabby. I heard from Brian. Annie.
Hey.
What's going on?
Not much. I'm 4.6 miles yesterday.
Oh, 4.6 miles.
Like on a hiking trail.
Oh my gosh, that's so cool.
Tell Steve we're almost in Maine, so we might have to do the Himalayas or something.
And my foot has a bunion.
Oh, well, that makes the 4.6 even more impressive.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. I saw the bunion for the rest of a week.
Well, it's great to see you, Annie.
Yeah, I might make out some brownies or cookies this week.
Delicious. Remember to take a photo.
Don't worry, I will.
That sounds good. All right. Christina, Brian, Rick. Did anybody see anybody that we haven't heard from yet? Linda. Linda Rao, are you there?
Yeah.
How are you?
Hi. Had a good weekend.
I'm glad. Did you do any exercise?
I did Zumba.
All right. I know you love Zumba. I'm glad to hear it.
I'm on TV too.
That's all right. Well, good to see you. Thanks for being here, Linda. All right. So last time on Monday, we played a new game. We played a scavenger hunt, and we're going to play the same game again this time. So I am going to play it like, I guess, kind of like musical chairs. So I'm going to give you a hint, and I'm going to start a song. And while the song is playing, you can go off and look. And when the song ends, or I stop the song, you come on back, and then we will share what we went to get. Your first scavenger hunt item this morning is something that smells good. Go find something that smells good.
Yeah, the bonnie boat was won as we sailed into the mystic. Oh, I can now hear the sailors cry. Smell the sea and feel the sky. Let your soul and spirit fly into the mystic. And where that foghorn blows, I will be coming home. Yeah, when the foghorn blows, I want to.
All right, so to your camera, hold up what you have that smells good to you. It's actually not what I was going to bring. Emma, what do you have there?
A jar of Skittles.
Wait, Skittles don't have a smell.
Oh, they do. magical fruity smell.
Folks, one time I flew home from Florida with Emma, and she had like 15 pounds of Skittles in her bag, and the airport security people thought she was crazy.
Well, that's what happens when you go to Costco in Florida.
It was, you're only there for a week. It was, yeah. She had a lot of Skittles in her bag. It was a little bit crazy.
Yeah.
What else we got? Ricky, what do you get there?
My mask.
It smells good?
Well, pretty much. I wear it all the time, and it's nice to, and it's nice to have while I'm like going out. Even wore it on my bike ride.
Nice job. That's being socially responsible. We appreciate that. Benny Majeski, you're going to like this one. Annie, what do you got there?
Diet Coke.
Diet Coke. Diet Coke in a can does have a distinct smell. Oh, that's yeah. A good one. Are you drinking that for breakfast, Annie?
Before breakfast.
Before breakfast. The pre-breakfast appetizer. Ben Majeski.
Me too, Annie. And I breakfast, lunch, breakfast and lunch. But I do have a monitor named Kiki Tripp monitoring my diet coke intake.
Good luck to Kiki. Good luck to her. Quick moment, Karen Pierce. What are you showing us?
I'm showing you my outdoor marsh. That smells really amazing.
That looks lovely.
That's it. Yeah, I can't really get a good picture, but it's pretty darn, it's very organic. Let's put it that way. It's definitely got a good earthy smell.
Smells like your happy place, I think, right?
Yes.
What else we got? Christina, what are you showing us?
Coffee.
Yeah, agreed. Coffee smells delicious.
Perfect in the corner.
Jillian, what's that?
It's like a type of a hair curling hair gel. It smells really good for your hair.
I like
and
it.
And it also smells good, garlic.
Thank you. Christina?
I am showing my Half Moon cupcakes, homemade.
Ooh. Delicious. There's a lot of baking going on up there in New Hampshire, I can tell you.
Yeah, I bake a lot now.
Brian Heffernan, what you got?
Chocolate chip cheesecake that Dad made yesterday was, as I mentioned briefly, It's the same day that Evie moved in.
Wow. Chocolate chip cheesecake. Those are like four.
And I'm coming over.
Yeah.
Especially since Dad's the cook in the house.
Socially distanced, though, so just throw it into Mark's mouth.
I have to put...
Yeah, he's got to put it back. That's safe. You might want to put it in the safe. Patrick, what do you got there?
I got an orange juice.
Perfect. Delicious. Ocean Spray, awesome. Classic.
Because it makes me... I like how it's orangey and I like how it's juicy.
Do you like the juicy wiggle as well?
Yes.
So there you go. Those things all go together. All right. The next item on our scavenger hunt. You're going to find something musical. Find something musical. So you have a couple minutes to find something musical.
Na 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 na. Na 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 na, yeah. You are the music in me. You know the words once upon a time make you listen. There's a reason. When you dream, there's a chance you'll find a little laughter or happy ever after.
Your harmony to the melody, it's echoing inside my head. A single voice above the noise, and like a common thread, you're pulling me.
When I hear my favorite song, I know that we belong.
Oh, you are the music in me. Yeah, it's living in all of us.
Yeah. Yes. Music and Zac Efron, a good way to start any day, especially a Monday. So what, Heffernan, what you got there?
Hamilton, your last name, your middle name.
That's right, buddy. Hey, are you pumped? Hamilton's coming to Disney Plus?
Yeah, I heard that.
The original Broadway cast. I am so excited for that.
And your brother's first name, too.
Yes, correct. Yes, it's basically the story of our family.
Andy, what does Patrick have? Oh, you muted yourself, Andy.
Rudy, what do you got?
I got a soundtrack from Aladdin.
Nice. Oh, from Aladdin? Is that a tape? Is that a cassette tape?
Yes.
Nice.
Yes, Rudy.
I got two favorite artists.
Nice. Awesome. That is a good one. Now, who are we going to, Patrick?
Patrick. I got him. Hi, Patrick.
Hello. I got the electric guitar with me that I played for music.
That is awesome, Patrick.
It's Paul Stanley's guitar.
It's Paul Stanley's guitar?
Yeah.
Now, for folks who might not know, who's Paul Stanley?
From Kiss. From Kiss.
Wow. That's Kiss. A lot of you know Kiss. I Want to Rock and Roll All Night is a really good one, too. The song Beth is Kiss, right, Beth?
Yes.
Awesome. Osborne, you love music, right?
Yeah, Brick.
You like
it was fun.
Brick by Ben Folds Five. So Ryan loves this song.
Oh yeah.
Someday, buddy, we'll be back together and we'll play the piano and we'll do that one. Let's see, who else we got? What are you showing us? Jillian, what's that?
Shane got me this cup for me and in High School Musical.
Oh, High School Musical. High School Musical 1?
I didn't say High School Musical 1, but it is High School Musical 2.
Cool.
Jillian, did you hear the song I was playing while people
Yes, I sing it.
That's the best part of High School Musical 2 is that song.
Because I have it cut now. Woohoo!
Yeah. Thanks, Jillian. Louis, what do you got?
I just went to type of musicals that they released heard of, which is The Waitress.
Oh my God, I love that, with Sarah Bareilles.
Oh yeah,
Adam, I'm obsessed with Sarah Bareilles.
Because it's my favorite about the all on time, which is School of Rock.
School of Rock is a good one. Adam, everybody on here, if you haven't heard the song "You Matter to Me" from Waitress, you got to go look it up. Mm-hmm. It's unbelievable. There's a version with Keith Mraz, which is
just a musical with my folks. I just went to a musical. I think it's called Get on Your Feet.
Really? Was it good?
Oh yeah.
Is that the James Brown one?
No, it is not.
What was that one about?
I don't know.
It's all right. Get on your feet. I'll look it up. Find it out. It'll be awesome. Thanks, Lou. Now, Patty, this is important. Is that what I think it is? What is that?
Spotlight is.
That's awesome.
Coffee with Andy right now. We're at Spotlighters. So there you go. Nice job, Patty. Emma or Karen or Carrie Lee, does anybody have our next scavenger hunt clue? Find something that is purple. Find something purple. Purple. Find something purple. All right, what do people have that is purple? I grabbed my Camp Echo Bridge water bottle that is purple. That is a go-to. Good to have water near you, too. Let me see. Who's someone we haven't heard too much from that has something purple? Annie, what's that?
This is a pencil case.
A purple pencil case. Perfect. Very cool. What else we got? Wendy, what do you have?
I think she's on the phone.
I think we're on the phone. I thought she was holding that up. Carolee, what do you have? Can you unmute yourself?
I have a purple candle I got for Christmas.
Oh, nice.
A pretty purple jar. It's very smelly nice.
Oh, so you hit multiple clues. Something that smells good and that is purple.
Right. I should have grabbed this first.
Yeah. Heffernan, you're like, you got everything this morning. What's that?
Thank you. A purple teapot. I don't know what's significant to my family, though.
Something important.
I guess so.
Dale, that looks comfortable. What's that?
A blanket.
With a purple square. Blanket. Perfect. Nick, did you find something purple?
Yes, I have these pens.
Purple pens.
Nice.
Very cool. Nice job, Nick.
Thank you.
And let's go to one more person.
Patrick has something really big.
Patrick, what do you got?
A purple vest.
A purple. Oh. Vest season is the best season, Patrick, right?
Best season because...
That looks pretty nice. I feel like we might have seen that. Did that come to a dance party at some point?
No.
No? Well, that's pretty cool. Thanks for sharing, Patrick. All right, folks. I see other people holding things up, but we have reached the end of Coffee with Andy. So thank you so much for coming. I hope you had a really great time. I hope you have a wonderful Monday. We hope to see you today at more programs and this week. Remember to keep tracking your activities so that you can help us hike the Appalachian Trail and bake delicious things, take pictures, and send them to us so that we can pretend to eat them with you. Everything's gluten-free when it's a picture, Benny. Don't worry, dude. So have a wonderful day. We will see you all later.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye, everybody.
Bye, amigos. Bye.